a short-term memory.
So she can't remember anything?
No. She has all of her long-term memory. That's a different part of the brain. Her whole life, up to the night before the accident, she remembers. She just can't retain any new information. It's like her slate gets wiped clean every night while she sleeps. Because each morning she wakes up thinking it's October 13th of last year. She comes here for breakfast because that's what she did on Sundays, and October 13th was a Sunday. She has no idea it's more than a year later.
Lucy is a young woman with anterograde amnesia whose family tricks her into believing every day is October 13th, the day of the car accident that caused her amnesia. What the movie says is true. Anterograde amnesia allows brains to encode new memories, but they are made inaccessible to that person, so he or she doesn't realize that the memories exist. He or she will perpetually believe that it's the day when the amnesia started, just like Lucy does. Anterograde amnesia is typically caused by brain damage, most often to the hippocampus region. In the film, Lucy has permanent brain damage due to a car accident.
Temporal lobe was severely damaged in the accident, but what we believe is the scar tissue here is impairing your ability to convert short-term memory into long-term memory while you sleep. The condition has come to be known as Goldfield syndrome.
This is entirely fiction. There is no such thing as Goldfield syndrome. The term that describes her condition is anterograde amnesia.
You should meet 10-second Tom.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce to you our most distinguished clinical subject, Tom.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Henry.
Marlon.
Doug.
Lucy.
Hi.
Oh, those are cool flip-flops. Where'd you get them?
You like those? It's an interesting story. I was over in the North Shore the other day.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Huh? Henry.
Hi.
Marlon.
Tom lost part of his brain in a hunting accident. His memory only lasts 10 seconds.
Tom's condition is realistic. The type and extent of brain damage causing anterograde amnesia can vary, which leads to large discrepancies between individuals for how long their short-term memory lasts. 10-second Tom is likely inspired by an English amnesia patient named Clive Waring, who could only remember things for 7 seconds.
Callahan Institute is the leading brain injury clinic in the Pacific Rim. We are funded out of Sandusky, Ohio, by T.B. Callahan, the automotive components tycoon.
Most people who have severe amnesia are forced to live in a hospital setting to be closely monitored and protected, like the patients shown in 51st States' Callahan Institute.
I don't know who you are, Henry, but I dream about you almost every night. Why?
What would you say if I told you that notebook you read every day used to have a lot of stuff about me in it?
I would say that that makes a lot of sense.
This is surprisingly plausible. Not just a happy ending because this is a comedy movie. With anterograde amnesia, new memories are in fact being encoded and stored in the brain. The problem is that the patient can't access those memories. However, we know that amnesia patients can still be affected by these memories, in surprising and interesting ways. For example, Clive Waring didn't recognize his children. However, he did continue to recognize his wife, despite her aging 20 or 30 years. And he never showed surprise that she had aged when she visited. He never showed surprise when he looked in the mirror and saw that he had become an old man, either.
Martha Stewart was in New York today to face charges.
This is accurate. Patients with anterograde amnesia typically have a journal where they document what they did that day. They read it every morning when they wake up because they've forgotten everything that has happened since they developed amnesia. Henry made this video for Lucy, and after watching it, she makes a journal where she writes down everything she wants to remember.